than toys that could transform. So in 1985, when we got M.A.S.K., everything was cool. Guys with powerful helmets that could do all kinds of special abilities, but it was their vehicles that could transform into powerful weapons. And every good guy has to have a bad guy. So we got the vicious evil network of mayhem known as Venom. And in my opinion, there was no cooler vehicle in Venom than the Jackhammer, driven by Cliff Dagger. So today, we're going to look at all the features of the Jackhammer in our first ever edition of After School Toys. Welcome back to another edition of Classic Plastics, and we have an awesome one today. As far as 80s toys go, I think we would both agree that this is one of our favorite.
Totally. I think this is one that we probably had the most fun with playing with as a kid were the M.A.S.K. toys, and this, in fact, was my M.A.S.K. toy. So now it resides in Ryan's collection, and I'm happy that it's there because it was rotting away in a shed at my mom's house. So what we have here is the Jackhammer, who was the guy?
Cliff Dagger.
So yes. This was a bad guy. What was the bad guy's?
Venom.
Venom. That's right. Okay. Thank you.
Vicious evil network of mayhem.
Wow.
That's what Venom's good for.
Man. Gold star for that. That's fantastic. So as you all know, again, another toy that in a way played off the Transformers thing, but it was really more of just taking a car and changing it into a different type of vehicle. My dad was a mechanic, so I always had an affinity for car type toys, and these were just the best that you could play with. Again, a Kenner toy, so the detail is just really great, and the mechanism and how everything works is just fantastic. So here you have what looks like I guess with Bronco or Daihatsu Rocky or something like that.
Yes.
But then it turns into this armored vehicle with guns and a machine gun turret. You press the
There you go. Pops up. There's a little gun in the side. I don't know if I could get it out there. We'll take a close up look at this in just a second. A little gun pops in like that. And Cliff Dagger can
sit in there
and pick off M.A.S.K. people with him. Let's get a closer look.
So here's
a closer look at it. What was your favorite feature on this one?
I just loved, basically the mechanism, how firm it was. It worked really well. It was just so neat that, you had this, catbird machine gun seat in the back of your Daihatsu Rocky or whatever it is. And just the fact that you had this, as a child, it looks like an innocent looking car, and then all of a sudden you had a machine gun that popped out the top. It was just a really great toy to play with.
If you're born with the name Cliff Dagger, you're probably going to work for the bad guys.
Or a soap opera.
Exactly. So yeah, very cool. I have to agree. I love the gun. But it's cool that he has armor plating that comes out to protect the windshield.
That's true. I always wonder about this little tiny 2-inch slit here, how really well you can see out of it. But when you're driving a car with a machine gun, you don't really have to see.
That's true. And there's probably something you guys can't see here, but in the very front, there's some little guns that actually move back and forth
right
when you roll it. So yeah.
Really cool action there. You could kind of hear it going off there. Let's see if we can do it this way.
Here it comes. So there you go. Awesome. Kenner could do no wrong in the 80s. I mean, let's just face it.
I totally agree.
Almost everything they put out was just amazing. And this is top of the line.
Totally agree. So, in my book, these were right after the Star Wars toys. I think, we were probably a little bit older when these came out. Like, these were probably, late 80s, 86, 87?
Yeah, we were probably in our late 20s. No, I'm just kidding.
We were in college.
Yeah, so we were still kids.
But I just thought these toys were fantastic. And fortunately, so did my mom. So she always seemed to get these for me. But,
1985.
I don't really remember these being as popular as the other toys. So you could really, as a kid, you could get good deals on them. Yes. And I just remember, Toys R Us or whatever would have a closeout, and you could go get a bunch of M.A.S.K. vehicles for a few bucks. So I think it's one of the most underrated toys of that time.
Absolutely. And the cartoon, we loved it as a kid, does not hold
it's
up.
It's terrible.
Like all
it's,
80s it's cartoons. It's terrible, but it's still, for nostalgia reasons, it's a lot of fun.
Definitely. So.
All right, well, there you go. 1985 Mask Jackhammer with Cliff Dagger. We hope you enjoyed the review, and we will see you next time for another edition of Classic Plastic.
See ya.